The Four Horsemen. Here they come. Chris Benoit, along with the sometimes self-proclaimed loose cannon, Lion Brian Pillman. Talk about a few screws loose.
I don't think it's screws loose. I think it's maybe a little cockiness going overboard.
Dynasty, baby.
I can imagine even Flair and Anderson wanting Pillman to quiet a little bit. He's making too many waves in the wrong place. The Horsemen are focused on one direction. The loose cannon is shooting cannonballs off in another.
Yeah, you make no mistake about it, Larry Legend. He is a loose cannon. But of the 90s, the young guys, the two young lines that they put in at Four Horsemen that Flair and Iron have chosen for this thing in the 90s, these two guys here really possess a great amount of talent. And if, you know, we're talking to Christopher Cruz later on, you know, so many big things going on WCW Saturday night. And if this thing gets underway and later on the program, we got big news for the fans.
Yeah, but the one thing about these two guys is sort of like, you know, uranium-235 and plutonium. They're great by themselves, but when you put them together,
I don't know what
they control?
I have no idea what you're saying.
Gentlemen, if
when
I
you
could
put
interrupt.
Them together, it's a nuclear bomb. See, and I think that's what Pillman is right here.
On sale, newsstands everywhere. It is the WCW Magazine. Relive the glory years of the Four Horsemen. The Horsemen, in fact, are on the cover. An expert assessment of the giant from both Dusty Rhodes and the living legend Larry Zbysko. And in the centerfold, the Harlem Heat. It is available January 16th on newsstands around the country. Make that everywhere. Would you like me, fans, to review just what the expert assessment of Dusty Rhodes is of the giant? Let me say real quickly. This giant is really raw, but he's just plain big, ugly, and mean. And the living legend Larry Zbysko says, the giant is
hey,
a great
a minute,
big man.
Wait a minute, right here, Pillman got dumped. You know what? I think he's just getting too cocky right here.
The world is this guy's oyster. You interrupted yourself. I was quoting you.
Well, we've seen a good arm drag, and you know, Pillman, we've seen a headlock. What other holds we see, Larry? You being a legendary.
An arm drag.
We're going to see every hold in the book, I think. There's the collar and elbow tie-up, and that is young Buck Quartermain in there with a full arm drag and twist on Pillman and the elbow. Just wanted to tell the fans that they could pick up the February edition of the WCW Magazine, January 16th.
Hey, right there, nice top wrist lock by Pillman's got the man. I think what Pillman's got to do is just forget about the crowd and just settle down. This guy's a good explosive athlete. There you go. Start thinking. Ring positioning. Make a lot of tags.
What? This guy is caught. That is a perfectly legal forearm and a snapmare. And Chris Benoit, as they say, is incredibly explosive. And surely he is going to play a role at Nitro, at WCW Saturday night, at the Clash of the Champions. Chris Benoit is so... I don't know, superlatives sometimes escape me when trying to describe the Canadian crippler. He's in now against Bart Sawyer, the collar and elbow tie-up, and
headlock,
very quickly,
headlock.
A standing side headlock. Bart Sawyer pushes up Benoit, and look at that shoulder block football tackle. Benoit gets some momentum. He's in the ropes. A block there by Sawyer. Look out! Sawyer is up. Benoit misses the lariat.
Good move.
And drops Chris Benoit.
Good move.
Sawyer. Hooks the leg, gets one, two on the Canadian crippler, and Pillman in there very quickly. Oh, no. Bart Sawyer was on a roll, and Benoit said, that is just about enough.
Look at Benoit, the snap. This guy can regain his balance quicker than I think anybody I've seen. Benoit, very explosive, but great, great center of gravity, great balance.
Yeah, he has great movement and is able to get out of situations, as Larry said, and come back. But right here, these two guys that I'm talking about, Benoit and Pillman, really seem to have their tag teaming together and know what they want to do.
He wants to be a hero.
What is it? Wants to be a hero. I'll talk to him. But let me tell you something about Nature Boy Ric Flair. Huge, huge news coming up tonight on WCW Saturday
Night.
Tell
us, tell us.
I mean, we'll talk about it as the show goes on. But tonight on WCW Saturday Night, the Nature Boy Ric Flair defends the world's heavyweight title, Chris Cruz, against the Macho Man Randy Savage, and what an event it will be this Saturday night.
Wow, that is possibly the biggest match ever in the history of WCW Saturday night. Hey, also, the U.S. title match, a controversial conclusion. The one-man gang faces Kensuke Sasaki. Part two of that special interview with Mike Ditka and a whole lot more.
Whoa.
And a chop there by Chris Benoit on Bart Sawyer. Oh, man. This is a mugging.
I tell you, the two horsemen here are making it look easy. They got great ring positioning, good control of Sawyer here. Nice snap by Benoit.
Wow, got him in the back of the head, too.
The snap suplex that he learned from the Dynamite Kid. That's Chris Benoit, and he drops Bart Sawyer on the small of his back, and now...
drapes him.
It sure does. Hey, still to come on the pro this morning, it's Eddie Guerrero. Also,
Excuse me, the American males
take on the stunt stable.
Excuse me, Larry was going to make... Yeah, okay, go ahead, Larry.
Apologizing.
Well, it's over now.
It's too late now.
Will never happen again. And Bart Sawyer, he's got some fire left in him, and he's trying to fight his way out of this.
He got the tag.
I get paid by the word. Obviously, you don't. There's Buck Quarterman. Nice drop kick. As I said, I get paid by the word. Obviously, you don't.
Right there, man. That's what I get paid for. Beating people up, Cruz, and analyzing it.
At the same time. You got Dusty in the corner.
No, he didn't. He hit Buck Quatermain. Wow, nice drop kick
the
in this suplex.
Nelson suplex. He's going to get the 1-2-3. Beautiful bridge. And Quatermain and Sawyer with no chance against the Horseman, Chris Benoit and Flying Brian Pillman. Gentlemen, need I remind you, recently Eric Bischoff on Nitro said of Pillman, his future may be very, very short as a member of the Four Horsemen and possibly as part of World Championship Wrestling.
If you watch these guys, you can see why Flair and Anderson recruited him into the Four Horsemen. Both very good, very explosive, very fast. They had their ring positioning down. Nice teamwork. But again, look at the attributes. Benoit just snaps the man.